Praise the Lord once again. We greet you in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. We invite you back again. Amen. To study God's word with us as we continue on this great subject concerning the Great Tribulation. And we're in chapter number 17, dealing with the woman sitting on the scarlet beast. Amen. With the gold cup in her hand and the seven heads. Praise the Lord. So we went over briefly. All right, the woman represents the great city. She's clothed with scarlet color. Mm-hmm. All right, and the beast represents government, world government, or political Babylon.
Yes.
All right, the golden cup reveals spiritual condition. All right, of the false religion, apostasy, Christianity. Mm-hmm. Babylon, or which was called the great whore or harlot. We went back and we talked about Babel because this is where the word Babylon came from. All right? There's a journey. There's a journey from Babel to Babylon, from Babylon to Rome. All right? So don't forget that. Babel to Babylon, Babylon to Rome.
All right.
All right. Now, Babel was represented by pride and rebellion against God. All right. Now, we want to go back now to chapter number 17. Now here comes John will be given the understanding because he marveled.
Mm-hmm.
And he needed an explanation. Read that in concerning the marveling.
And the angel said unto me.
The angel said unto me.
Wherefore didst thou marvel?
Wherefore didst thou marvel?
I will tell thee the mystery of the woman.
I will tell thee the mystery of the woman.
And of the beast that carrieth her.
All right, so the woman is sitting on the beast and the beast is upholding the woman.
Mm-hmm.
She has support. The beast is supporting the woman. Without the beast, the woman don't have anything to sit on.
Mm.
Now remember, the beast represents world government and political Babylon.
Alright.
Alright. Now chapter number 17 is dealing with religious Babylon.
Mm.
Chapter number 18 speaks about the political side of Babylon concerning commercialism.
Alright.
And concerning trade and wealth.
Alright.
Alright. So now let's keep reading.
Which had the seven heads.
Alright, now you see the seven heads.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, now let's explain what the seven heads mean. Okay. Praise the Lord. Do a little bit more reading. We'll come back.
And 10 horns.
Alright, so there's seven heads and 10 horns.
The beast that thou sawest was.
Alright, now the seven heads. Most Bible commentators believe these are the seven heads concerning the beast. Alright. But I believe there's a part that says five are falling. Let's read some more. I'll come back to it. Read.
The beast that sought
was
and is not and shall ascend out of the bottomless pit.
Are we still talking about the Antichrist?
And go into perdition.
Alright, no. The word perdition means everlasting punishment.
And they that dwell on the earth
shall wonder
whose names were not written in the book of life from the foundation of the world.
All right, so now when you get into church, that's not when your name got written up. It was already done from the foundation of the world. God already done had a number set. The number is set before the foundation of the world, who would be saved and who would not be saved.
Amen.
The number is set. So that's why God don't need the help of the preacher to come up with a number.
All right, Bishop.
That number was set before the foundation. That's why the Bible said, the Lord will add to the church such as should be saved. Not us preachers. Let the Lord do the adding.
Amen.
He knows who belong in the church and who don't belong in the church.
Amen.
All right, read.
When they behold the beast that was,
and is not,
and yet is,
here is the mind that hath wisdom,
the seven heads, are the seven mountains.
All right, the seven heads are the seven mountains. Now, I did some research concerning, amen, the mountains.
Mm-hmm.
Now, back in the days when Rome ruled, praise the Lord, they are known as what? The seven mountains represents seven mountains of Rome.
Mm-hmm.
These were all areas where the Romans lived and ruled. Now, Lord help me.
All right, Bishop.
In pronouncing them.
Bless them, Lord.
The first one is Palatine. Mm-hmm. The second one is Capitoline. Mm-hmm. The third one is Aventine. Mm-hmm. The fourth one is Caelius. The fifth one is Esquiline. Mm-hmm. The sixth one is Vimino. Oh, Lord have mercy. And the seventh one is
Quirinal.
Mm-hmm. All right. So these are the seven mountains over there next to the Tigris River. All right. And the Tigris River is right over there in Iraq. All right, it runs right there. All right, you see the Tigris River right over there in Iraq.
All right,
so those are the seven mountains.
On which the woman sat. There are seven kings. Five are fallen. And one is. And the other is not yet come.
Now, let me give my understanding of the seven kings.
All right.
Five are fallen. Mm-hmm. Fallen means they are no longer around as an empire. Mm-hmm. Now, most commentators believe the seven kings are Egypt, Assyria, Babylon, Medo-Persia, Greece, and at the time that John was writing, who was ruling? The Roman Empire. Mm-hmm. So he said, one is, he never told you the name of the one that is. Mm-hmm. But the Roman Empire was in rulership at that time when John was given, amen, these prophecies in the book of Revelation.
All right,
so the one that is the Roman Empire. And the next one is, read.
And the other is not yet.
All right, the other is not yet come. Now, I believe during the Great Tribulation, there will be a revived Roman Empire, which will be led not by none other than the Antichrist. Mm. Remember in Daniel chapter number 7, concerning that little horn. Mm-hmm. And the little horn came up right from among the Roman Empire. Mm-hmm. All right? So the Antichrist has some affiliation or connection to the Roman Empire. Mm. Now, I could be wrong, but I do believe Vatican City is the capital of the what? The Roman Catholic Church. The Bible said, John saw the woman with the blood of the what? Go back now to chapter 17. John saw the woman, that she was what? Clothed in the blood? With the blood of the martyr of the Lord. Right here in chapter 17. Right there in chapter 17. Praise the Lord. We'll get it. Verse 6. All right, let's go to verse 6.
And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints.
All right, she is drunken with the blood of the saints. Now, remember this now. I agree.
And with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus.
All right, now who was responsible for the slaughter of many of the Christians in the early days? Rome. Many of the prophets, many of the saints suffered under Rome. All right, so the Roman Catholic Church came out of the Roman Empire. Mm. And remember, Rome split it into two. Rome in the west, Constantinople in the east. Mm-hmm. Now, this is where, what they call it, Europe. Europe came about, amen, from the splitting of the Roman Empire.
All right.
Mm-hmm. A lot of Jews were scattered. You have many Jews that are living around the world. But during the Great Tribulation, the Lord will begin to do what? Bring back his people to their homeland. Their homeland is not America.
Amen.
Their homeland is the land of Israel that God promised to Abraham and his seed. Mm-hmm. Now, Israel right now is a very tiny country.
piece of land. Because many people, the Arabs, want to control that land.
That's right.
But it was not given to them.
No, sir.
It was given to Isaac. Praise the Lord. So Israel played a great part during the Great Tribulation. Hopefully I have some time to go through some more. All right, now, keep reading.
And the other is not yet come.
All right, the other is not yet come.
And when he cometh.
And when he cometh.
He must continue a short space.
All right, he must continue a short space.
And the beast that was.
The beast that was.
And is not.
And is not.
Even he.
Even he.
Is the eighth.
Even he is the eighth.
And is of the seven.
And is the seven.
And goeth into perdition.
All right, he will end up going into perdition, meaning when he is put in the lake of fire, because perdition means everlasting punishment. Mm-hmm. All right, read.
And the ten horns.
And the ten horns.
Which thou sawest.
Which thou sawest.
Are the ten kings.
All right, so the ten horns represents ten kings. Now, I believe these ten horns are ten nations of great political influence that will support the Antichrist. These ten nations will support the Antichrist. Because remember now, he wants to rule the world.
That's right.
And he will try to rule from Jerusalem, but yet he will have others that are working under him. Mm-hmm. Just like Jesus will be ruling where? From Jerusalem. Praise the Lord. But the saints will help Jesus, and there is no telling which country or which city the Lord Jesus will send you to.
Amen.
So serving the Lord does pay off.
Amen.
All right, read.
Which have received no kingdom as yet.
They have not received no kingdom as yet.
But receive power.
Receive power.
As kings.
As kings.
1 hour.
1 hour.
With the beast.
All right, so they receive what? No kingdom as yet, but they will rule with the beast. In other words, they will allow the beast, the Antichrist, amen, to be the head man.
Mm-hmm.
And they will support, amen, the beast.
Amen.
All right, read.
These have one mind.
These have one mind.
And shall give their power and
strength. They shall give their power and strength
unto the beast.
All right, you see what I just said? They will come under the control of the beast.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
These shall make war.
These shall make war.
With the Lamb.
With the Lamb.
And the Lamb.
And the Lamb.
Shall overcome them.
Shall overcome them. Now we know who the Lamb is.
The Lord of Lords.
So the beast and his army is going to make war against the Lamb and his army.
Mm-hmm.
But they can't make no war with the Lamb if the Lamb stays in heaven.
All right.
So this is why Jude said the Lord cometh with what? 10,000 of his saints to do what? Execute judgment upon all.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I want to cover two things real quick.
All right.
This woman represents wickedness,
mm-hmm.
immorality, sexual perversion,
mm-hmm.
fornication, sorcery.
Mm-hmm.
In times of judgment, God always used a woman to, you understand, to show his judgment that is pending. I'm going to show you something real quick, and then we're going to come. I want to, amen, go to another scripture. Deacon Malone, now I want you to read Zechariah chapter 5, verses 5 through 11. All right, help him out, Deacon, as we read. Zechariah 5, verses 5 through 11.
Then the angel that talked with me,
went forth,
and said unto me, lift up, now thine eyes,
mm-hmm.
and see what is this that goeth forth.
All right.
And he said,
what is it?
And he said,
mm-hmm.
this is an Antipath that
an ephod.
Mm-hmm.
Ephod that goeth forth.
Mm-hmm.
And he said moreover, this is their resemblance through all the earth. And behold, there was lifted up
a talent of lead.
And this is a woman.
Alright. So what is he seeing now? A woman. Alright, now the ephod is a measuring basket.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so it's a measuring basket, and the woman is in the basket. All right, read.
And behold, there was lifted up a gallon of lead.
All right.
And this is a woman that sitteth in the midst of the ephod.
All right.
And he said, this is wickedness.
All right, so the woman represents what? Wickedness. Just like this great city and the false religion represents wickedness. Read.
And he cast it into the midst of the ephod.
All right.
And he cast the weight of the lead upon the mouth thereof. Then lifted up I my eyes, and behold, there came out two women. And the wind was in their wings, for they had wings like the wings of a stork.
All right.
And they lifted up the ephod between the earth.
And the heaven.
And the heaven.
Then said I, angel, that talk with me, whither do these beat the ephod? And he said unto me, to build it an house in the land of Shinar.
All right, so now you see now, it's going right back to Shinar. Shinar is right back from the days of Babylon, which represents Babylon. Now remember, you have to travel from Babel to Babylon, all right, to Rome. The false religion is under the leadership of the Roman Catholic Church. And they represent wickedness. That's why I said the other day, and I hope nobody don't get mad at me. According to the Word of God, the Catholic religion is not of God. It's the devil's religion. And anybody that believes it, how can they be saved? Praise the Lord. You see what goes on among the Catholic Church? It's not of God. And they believe a lie. Hail Mary, Mother of God. Praise the Lord. Mary never gave birth to God. She gave birth to a son. Praise the Lord. So the devil have his church, and the Catholic Church have a great reach around the entire world. Their influence goes around the entire world. You see how many people go over there to Vatican City? And you see what their head man is called, the Pope? And they call him what? Father? Holy Father? There's only one Holy Father, and that is God.
Amen.
Let me say this. Don't be mad at me, but the Pope is saved. Not according to salvation. It's the truth.
Amen.
But look how many millions of people that follow that religion. But it's not of God. That's not the only religion that is not of God, but that's the main one. All right, now, going back to where Deacon Lee was. Go back to chapter 17.
He is the Lord of lords.
He is the Lord of lords.
And King of kings.
And King of kings.
And they that are with him.
They that are with him.
Are called.
Are called.
A chosen.
A chosen.
And faithful.
All right. So those that will be with Jesus will be de-called, chosen, and what? And faithful. Those are the characteristics of those that will be able to come back with Jesus to fight the battle of Armageddon. Now, I want to give you another description in the book of Zechariah chapter number 14. Deacon, you get me Zechariah 14, verse number 1. Zechariah 14, verse number 1.
Behold, the day of the Lord cometh.
The day of the Lord cometh.
And they spoil,
the spoil
shall be divided in the midst of thee.
Shall be divided in the midst of thee.
For I will gather all nations.
The Lord said, I will gather all nations.
Against Jerusalem.
Against who?
Jerusalem.
So you see who's doing the gathering?
The Lord.
The Lord will put it in their heart to come against Jerusalem.
To battle.
So that's why I said when you decide to get saved, it wasn't you.
Amen.
It was the Lord that opened up your heart and give you a mind to be saved. Right. So everything going on during the Great Tribulation, it is done and inspired by the will of God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Read.
And the city shall be taken.
The city of Jerusalem shall be taken.
And the houses rifled.
All right.
And the women ravished.
All right. You know what's going to happen to the Jewish women.
Mm.
The Gentile men that will come down there, amen, going to have a field day with the Hebrew women. The women will be what? Ravished. They're going to take advantage. The children of the Israelites will suffer the most during the Great Tribulation.
I know.
All right, keep reading. While you're reading that, Deacon Malone, get me Daniel chapter number 12. All right, keep reading, Deacon Lee.
And half of the city, shall go forth, into captivity.
Into captivity.
And the residue, of the people, shall not be cut off, from the city.
From the city. During the Great Tribulation, many Jewish people will die. But there will be a residue, in other words, a remnant.
Mm-hmm.
Because the Bible said, though the children of Israel be like the sand of the sea, only a remnant shall be saved.
Mm.
It's a set number that God has.
Amen.
Not all, amen, that are called Jews will be saved.
Amen.
Many of them will suffer greatly. Because why? They rejected the Lord Jesus Christ as their Messiah.
Amen.
They did not believe that he was the Messiah that came from God. So the Jewish people will suffer greatly. All right, read.
Then shall the Lord go forth.
All right, now. Then shall the Lord go forth.
And fight against those nations.
All right, so now we're back now. Let's say the Lord will go forth and fight with those nations, the ten kings and the beasts.
As when he fought in the day of battle.
As in the day of battle. Read.
And his feet.
And his feet.
Shall stand in that day.
Shall stand in that day.
Upon the Mount of Olives.
On the Mount of Olives. Remember now, in Luke chapter 24 and Acts chapter number 1, they returned from Jerusalem, from the Mount of Olives.
Mm-hmm.
Before Jesus ascended into heaven, he was on the Mount of Olives.
Amen.
This was a well-known place where Jesus and his disciples would go and hang out.
Mm-hmm.
All right, the Mount of Olives overlooked the old city, the old Jerusalem city.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so now when Jesus comes again, yes, with the army, his feet will be planted on the Mount of Olives.
Which is before Jerusalem.
Which is before Jerusalem.
On the east.
On the east.
And the Mount of Olives.
And the Mount of Olives.
Shall cleave in the midst thereof.
All right. So now there will be something that will cause, amen, an interruption.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. It might be an earthquake. We don't know. But there will become a separation. There must be a separation between the east and the west.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
Therefore, toward the east, and toward the west, there shall be a very great valley.
All right, so this had to happen so that there can be a very great valley. Now, I'm wondering if that valley is the same valley that is known as the valleys of the king, or known as Jehoshaphat, the valley of Jehoshaphat. It could be that same valley.
Mm-hmm.
All right, but this must happen before. You understand? Those people come against Jerusalem.
That's right.
All right, read.
And half of the mountain.
Half of the mountain. Shall be removed.
Toward the north.
Toward the north.
And half of it toward the south.
And half of it toward the south.
And ye shall flee.
And ye shall flee.
To the valley of the mountain.
To the valley of the mountain.
For the valley of the mountains,
mm-hmm,
shall reach unto Azal.
All right.
Yea. Ye shall flee.
Ye shall flee.
Like as ye fled from before the earthquake,
mm-hmm,
in the days of Azariah.
All right. You see, I just mentioned the earthquake. All right. Read.
Azariah. King of Judah.
All right.
And the Lord my God shall come.
The Lord my God shall come.
And all the saints with thee.
All right. You see that now? The Lord will come, Jesus, with all saints with him.
And it shall come to pass.
It shall come to pass.
In that day.
In that day.
That the light.
The light.
Shall not be clear.
Shall not be clear.
Nor dark.
Nor dark.
But it shall be one day.
It shall be one day.
Which shall be known to the Lord.
Which shall be known to the Lord.
Not day.
Not day.
nor night.
Nor night.
But it shall come to pass.
It shall come to pass.
And at evening time.
At evening time.
It shall be light.
It shall be light. Now this is the same thing that happened in the book of Joshua.
Mm-hmm.
Chapter number 10.
That's right.
When those 10 kings came against those group of people and they called Joshua down.
Mm-hmm.
While Joshua was fighting.
Yeah.
And the sun was about to go down.
That's right.
And the moon was about to come out.
Mm.
And Joshua spoke to the sun and said, "Sun, stand still.
Yes, sir.
Until the battle is over."
Yes.
You understand? Because if the sun went down and the moon came up, then the enemies would be able to escape. So God heard the voice of Joshua and he caused the sun to keep on shining while the moon was getting ready to come out.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. This is what he's talking about there in the book of Zechariah. Read.
"And it shall be in that day."
It shall be in that day.
"That living waters."
Living waters.
"Shall go out from Jerusalem."
Shall go out from Jerusalem.
"Half of them."
Half of them.
"Toward the former sea."
Toward the former sea.
"And half of them."
And half of them.
"Toward the hinder sea."
Toward the hinder sea.
"In summer."
In summer.
"And in winter."
And in winter.
"Shall it be."
Shall it be.
"And the Lord shall be king over all the earth."
All right. He shall be what? King over all the earth. This is what Daniel saw in chapter number 2. The stone that was hewn out from the mountain.
Mm-hmm.
"In those days shall the Lord God set up a kingdom that shall never be destroyed." And Jesus' kingdom will destroy all these other kingdoms.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, because he will be King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and he will rule from Jerusalem. Read.
"And the Lord shall be king over all the earth."
He's going to be king over all the earth.
"In that day."
In that day.
"Shall there be one Lord."
There's going to be one Lord.
"And his name one."
All right, and his name one.
"All the land shall be turned as a plain."
Mm-hmm.
"From Geba to Rimmon, south of Jerusalem."
Yes.
"And it shall be lifted up."
Shall be lifted up.
"And inhabited."
And inhabited.
"In her place."
In her place.
"From Benjamin's gate."
From Benjamin's gate.
"Unto the place of the first gate."
All right.
"Unto the corner's gate."
Mm-hmm.
"And from the tower of Hanael unto the king's wine press."
All right.
"And men shall dwell in it."
Men shall dwell in it.
"And there shall be no more utter destruction."
All right. When the Messianic kingdom is on this earth, there will be no more destruction. You know why? Because the devil will be placed in the bottomless pit for 1,000 years. And I said last week, you will never get peace with the devil in your house. The only time you're going to get peace is when you get kicked him out your house.
Mm-hmm.
If you entertain him, you're entertaining destruction and trouble.
Amen.
But once you get rid of it, then, you understand, there'll be no trouble.
Amen.
All right, read.
But Jerusalem shall be safely inhabited.
Jerusalem shall be safely inhabited.
"This shall be the plague."
This shall be the plague.
"Wherewith the Lord will smite all the people."
All right, the Lord will smite all the people.
"That have fought against Jerusalem."
All right, those that fought against Jerusalem, the Lord will, you understand, smite them.
"Their flesh."
Their flesh.
"Shall consume."
Uh-huh.
"Away."
Their flesh is going to consume away.
"While they stand upon their feet."
So while they're standing upon their feet, their flesh shall be what?
Consumed
away.
"And their eyes."
And their eyes.
"Shall consume away."
Shall consume away.
"In their hole."
Oh, Lord have mercy. Have you ever seen the movie The Mummy?
Mm.
Praise the Lord. Huh?
Mm.
This is what's going to happen to the enemy of God. While they're standing on their feet, their flesh is going to what?
Consume
away. Consume away. And their eyes is going to what?
Consume away.
It's going to consume away right in their head.
"And their tongue."
"And their tongue."
"Shall consume away in their mouth."
Oh, hallelujah. Don't mess with God.
Mm.
And don't mess with the children of Israel. Read.
Lord. "And it shall come to pass."
It shall come to pass.
"In that day."
In that day.
"That a great tumult."
Mm-hmm.
"From the Lord shall be among them."
All right.
"And they shall lay hold everyone on the hand of their neighbor."
Mm-hmm.
"And his hand shall rise up against the hand of his neighbor."
All right.
"And Judah."
And Judah.
Also. "Shall fight at Jerusalem."
Shall fight at Jerusalem.
"And the wealth."
Mm-hmm.
"Of all the heathen."
Of all the heathen
round about
shall be gathered together
gold and silver and apparel
in great abundance
and so shall be the plague of the horse,
all right,
of the mule,
mm-hmm,
of the camel and of the ass and of all the beasts that shall be in these tents as this plague.
All right.
And it shall come to pass.
Shall come to pass.
That everyone that is left.
Everyone that is left.
Of all the nations.
Of all the nations.
Which came against Jerusalem.
That came against Jerusalem.
Shall even go up. From year to year.
From year to year.
To worship the King.
All right. So every nation that are not considered as a Jewish nation,
mm-hmm,
must go to Jerusalem once a year.
Amen.
Just like the Muslim, in one time in their lifetime, must make that pilgrim journey over to Mecca.
Mm-hmm.
Every Muslim, within their lifetime on this earth, they must pay a visit over to Mecca.
Mm-hmm.
Those that are not Jewish, when Jesus set up his kingdom, they must all go to Jerusalem. They must go, because if they don't go, listen to what will happen to them. Read.
Worship the King. The Lord of hosts. And to keep the feast of what? Of the tabernacle.
All right. The feast of tabernacles was given to the children of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
When they came out of Egypt, amen, God reminded them to keep the feast of tabernacles.
Mm-hmm.
And the feast of tabernacles was to remind them of where God brought them from.
That's right.
And where they are right now. God never wanted Israel to forget where they were and what God did to them. That's why God even warned them, make sure that you treat strangers right.
That's right.
Because at one time you was a stranger in the land of Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
And I deliver you out. So don't go around treating strangers wrong.
Amen.
All right, read.
And it shall be.
It shall be.
That whoso will not come.
Whosoever will not come.
Up of all the families of the earth.
All right, if you refuse to go to Jerusalem.
Unto Jerusalem to worship.
Unto Jerusalem to worship.
The King. The host of the Lord of hosts.
The Lord of hosts.
Even upon them. Shall be no rain.
All right. So if any nation refuse to go to Jerusalem, why Jesus is ruling on this earth, the Messianic age, where he will sit on his father's David throne, amen, for 1,000 years, you will not be blessed. You will be cursed.
Mm-hmm.
Even though Jesus is in Jerusalem,
mm-hmm,
you best remember, his father sees everything.
I know.
And if you refuse to go to Jerusalem and worship his son,
right,
that which should have been a blessing on your community, mm-hmm, now has become a curse.
My Lord.
So when the curse comes upon your city, then you realize you are insufficient of yourself.
Mm.
You got to obey God's word. Just like God told John, go take the book out of the hand of the angel.
Uh-huh.
You know what John did? He walked over to the angel and said, give me the book. Angel said, not me. Didn't you hear what God just said?
You need to take the book.
He said, take the book. And you coming up to me and tell me, give me the book. The angel said, not me, take it.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? You got to take it. In other words, everything is going to be done according to order.
That's right.
Now, let me say this as people don't get ready to read it, and we're going to close out. During the millennium,
mm-hmm,
the only thing that will rule during that time is death.
That's right, Bishop.
People will still die. They will be born,
mm-hmm,
but they will still die. They're going to live a long time,
mm-hmm,
but they will die.
That's right.
During that 1,000 years, according to Isaiah chapter number 11, even the animals will get along.
Mm. All right.
The lion and the bear are going to get along.
Peace on earth.
Now you try putting the lion and the bear and tell them to get along right now.
Look out.
The reason why they can't get along, because the spirit of the devil is here.
Mm.
But once the devil is bound and the King of Kings and the Prince of Peace is on the earth, mm, now the animals will have peace among themselves. Huh? They will be able to play, and a child is going to be able to go and put his hands on the cockatrice dead or nest, and it will not hurt the child.
Harm.
Now let that child go messing with a snake right now.
Mm.
Let him go pick up a snake and see what happens. But during the 1,000 years of peace, you're going to be able to walk up to a snake and pet the snake.
Mm-hmm.
And the snake ain't going to new and ugly. You're going to walk up to a lion and rub the lion's
mane.
Rub his mane. And speak to him, and he's just going to look at you and smile.
Okay.
Now try doing that right now. I bet you you'll become his meal, whether it be dinner, lunch, or breakfast. Praise the Lord. But once the devil's spirit is put away, then there will be peace on earth and goodwill to all men, because the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, is now on the earth, and he is known as the what? The Prince of Peace. Now, I want to close out. Like I said, the children of Israel will suffer greatly. Now, let's close out now in Daniel chapter number 12, verse number 1. Daniel 12, verse number 1.
And at that time,
Michael,
stand up. The great prince which standeth for the children of people, of that people.
All right, so let me explain that real quick. Michael is known as the archangel. And I believe Michael was more powerful than Satan.
Amen, Bishop.
Because when Daniel prayed, and the Lord dispatched Gabriel to bring the answer to Daniel, the prince of Persia withstood him.
That's right. Hindered him.
All of those empires that I named was under the influence of a demonic ruler. They were governed by a demonic ruler. That's why sometimes you see certain leaders act certain way. There is a demonic rule that is influencing them to act the way they do.
Amen.
And I go on record to say this. One is controlling Mr. Trump.
All right, now.
True.
Amen.
So Daniel was waiting for the answer. Gabriel couldn't get through to bring the answer to Daniel. And there was a battle in the air. Nobody knew what was happening because it's a spiritual warfare.
That's right. That's right.
So when God saw that Gabriel was held up for 21 days.
Michael.
He said, hey, Michael, go handle my, you know what I'm saying? My life job. Michael came.
And free Gabriel.
And free Gabriel up. Said, Gabriel, hey, you go.
Go ahead, finish.
I'll take care of this right here.
Finish.
Praise the Lord. Because Daniel needed understanding of what's going on.
Yeah.
So when Gabriel came, Gabriel told Daniel, from the day that you began to pray and make your supplication, God heard you. And he sent me, but the prince of the Persia withstood me. That's why the Bible said Satan is known as the prince of the power of the air.
Amen.
Satan controls the airway.
I know.
You don't see certain things. We fly in planes and don't even know what's going on around us. Sometimes demonic forces wanted to bring that plane down, but the Lord got angels watching over us.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. If the Lord will open up our eyes to some spiritual things, some of us will probably pass out.
That's right, Bishop.
Praise the Lord.
I leave home.
So now, let me close up real quick. So, Daniel was given the explanation. Gabriel told him. But Gabriel said, no, I got to go back. And when I leave here, the prince of what? Greece is coming. So even Greece was under the control of a demonic ruler.
Amen.
All of those empires were under the rule of a demonic ruler. So Daniel received the understanding. So no, Michael, the archangel, is given the charge to watch over Israel. Notice God didn't give any angel over Israel.
Not just any angel.
He gave Michael one to protect the nation of Israel. So whenever you hear about Michael, you got to think about Israel.
All right.
No nation will be able to defeat Israel because Michael is their prince.
Amen.
So even if the devil comes against them, he can't stand against them because they got a prince. Read.
And the great prince, which standeth for the children of the people, of that people, and there shall be a time of trouble.
Great time of trouble.
Such as never was since. There was a nation, even to the same time, and at that time thy people shall be delivered.
All right, so the children of Israel will go through much tribulation. They're going to suffer, but they will be what?
Delivered.
The Lord Jesus will come and deliver his brothers and sisters. And let me say this, Jesus is not a Gentile. He's a Jew. God is not a Gentile, neither is God a Jew. You hear what I just said?
Yeah.
Jesus is not a Gentile, but he's a Jew. God is neither a Gentile or a Jew, but he is the God of the Jews.
Amen.
So never make Jesus God. That's simple.
Amen.
Amen. So thank God. Amen for this great Bible study. As we come down to a close, make sure that you hear his voice and harden not your heart. He's coming.
Yes, sir.
How many want to be ready?
Amen.
The only way you can get ready, they give you the instruction. You went to the pharmacist and told them they diagnosed you in the hospital with a sin symptom. And in order to get rid of your sin symptom, you must repent and be baptized, every one of you, how? In the name of Jesus Christ, for what? The remission of your sins, and ye shall receive what? The gift of the Holy Ghost. You can escape the great tribulation.
Amen.
You don't have to go through it. You can escape it, but you got to accept Jesus. You got to live right.
Amen.
And you got to do right. And remember, I don't know it all, but I do thank God for what I do know.
Amen.
And we're never going to get puffed up.
Oh, no.
We're never going to holler our head to get beat. Because that which we know, if God don't reveal it, who can know it?
Nobody.
And I don't have nothing to glory in. Real quick, Galatians 6:14. Real quick. Keep me on. Real quick. Galatians 6:14. If any one of the three of us ever think we know it all
right, Bishop.
And we get lifted up in pride because we sitting up at this table, if we want to glory, Paul going to tell us what we glory in.
But God forbid.
God forbid.
That I should glory.
That the three of us should glory.
Saved in the cross.
All right, we got nothing to boast about because we sitting up here and God blessing us.
Amen.
We stay humble before the Lord, is that right?
Amen. Amen.
Don't let our hands get lowered. We stay humble before the Lord.
Amen.
God forbid that I should glory.
Saved in the cross.
If you want to glory, glory in the cross.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ.
You know the cross represents suffering.
That's right.
Glory in your suffering. Read.
By whom the world is crucified unto me.
By whom the world is crucified unto me.
And I unto the world.
And I unto the world. Keep us in prayer.
Amen.
Because my desire is to ever walk humble before the Lord. Because I want to help declare his generation.
Amen.
I'm excited about the word of God. So pray for this young bishop. And I want you to know I have much more to learn. But guess what? I'm teachable. I'm instructable. And I'm learnable. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. In Jesus' name. Thank you.